right, men? Today we're going to evaluate ourselves as a unit, and one of the things that all units must do first is look at the weakest link in the chain, because we're only as strong as that weakest link, and one of the weakest links in our chain is the dreaded simp. Now, when the simp comes to mind, we usually think it's just some brother that's looking to get brownie points with women by joining their cheering section. And while that is true in many and most cases in which simps are involved, we need to seriously look into this character, because the reality is that there are at least 5 different types of simps out there. And in today's lesson, we're going to evaluate and define each type of simp so we can better guard ourselves against them. Okay, now the first simp that we're going to talk about is the pathetic simp. Now, the pathetic simp is similar to a pathetic drunk who will drown himself in sorrow after tossing back a few shots of liquor, except the pathetic simp doesn't need any alcohol, drugs, or intoxicants of any nature, because his woman is the depressant that is keeping him immersed in pain. Now, we all know this dude. The pathetic simp is that cat who you used to smash mugs and break bread with, that sits around in the dark all day long by himself now at the crib, crying, "Man, I don't believe she giving up that pussy. I love that girl, man. Why she doing this to me?" And as much as you and the other friends try to get this dude to get her off his mind and just enjoy life, he just remains daydreaming and thinking about this woman all day long. Okay, I have a buddy of mine who I've known since we were kids who fits this build. Okay, me and the other homies would check on him and roll past his home to see how he was doing, and every time it never failed, okay? He would always be teary-eyed and choked up, looking at old wedding photos while his wife was busy screwing around on him. Me and the crew would see if he wanted to go out, drink a few beers, catch a game, go fishing, bowling, or roll to a cookout that we knew, you know, was going to be loaded with fine-ass women. And this fool would either tell us that he couldn't do it because he was waiting on that Jezebel of a better half of his, or he would come along and spoil the fun for everybody because he would be whining the entire time, scrolling through his phone, looking at some more old pictures, talking about, "Yeah, that's me and my baby the day that I took her out to the Cheesecake Factory." And before I go forward, I want to be clear about what makes men like this simps, because any man can be cheated on at any given moment by any female. But what makes a man with this behavior a simp is the fact that when you and the rest of the fellas offer this man some sound advice about how to deal with his woman, after he comes to you begging and pleading for your honest opinion, he always goes right back to her and tells her everything that you said.
"Now, aren't you tired of being a cream puff? Damn, yeah, I am. Well, say it. I am tired of being a cream puff." "Louder. I am tired of being a cream puff." "Yeah, that's it. That's the way it is. Have another drink. That's the attitude I want you to keep up. Now, I want you to have that attitude all
I'm not going to be a cream puff
Don't
anymore.
Don't be no cream puff.
A cream puff, am I?
Yeah, wake up when you want it.
That's
do what the idea
is. That's a good idea. You said she would be eating out of the palm of my hand. Here, I wash my hands for nothing." "Is that what you told him, sucker?"
I was only trying to help him out. Come on, Woodrow, this is where the cream puff meets the battle axe."
"Who you calling the battle axe, chump? Yeah, who you calling the battle axe, chump?"
"Well, let me see. There's 1, 2, 3. Take your choice."
"Woodrow, you gonna stand here and let this Harry Ape call me a battle axe?
No, wait just a minute, Harry Ape. This battle axe happens to be my wife."
"Talk to him, Woodrow."
"Now, you can't talk to my wife like that." I'm sorry about all this.
The next simp we're going to shine some light on is the old school simp. And old school simps really aren't simps. What they are is old school players who have graduated to another level of the game. And what they do is they use the simp position to stay in the good graces of the ladies so they can remain relevant and up to date.
All the single ladies, throw your hands up. How y'all doing?
His initial reaction?
All y'all fine. Hell, who don't want to go out with y'all?
Men my age have made a mistake in that we didn't teach the generation behind us the principles of manhood.
There are so many African-American men missing, absent in the family.
His advice? Go for the older man.
You have a biological clock. We don't.
The old school simp is constantly checking younger players to get the females rooting for them. You find many of these men sitting on your pulpit every Sunday, chastising every man in the community, while women are busy fanning themselves off and yelling hallelujah.
Thank you so much for inviting us into your home. I'm Bishop Magic Wand, founder and pastor of the Magic World Christian Kingdom Church. And at this time, I'd like to share Psalms 31:51 with you.
Many of these men also hold long-time careers in law enforcement, or they work with the courts, because criminal justice careers are pussy-catching jobs. I mean, I've had plenty of officers tell me straight up that if you can't get some action while you're on the beat, something is wrong with you. The divorce rates are extremely high because wives usually have a bunch of women chasing after their husbands. I mean, another thing is the fact that those jobs are easy ways to show women that they are doing, you know, that the men are doing much better than many other men in the populace, be they troublemakers, baby daddies, and other so-called bad boys that these self-proclaimed damsels in distress just can't seem to dodge and stay away from. And the old-school simp is forever whispering in some gullible sister's ear that if she wants to be treated with some class, come lean on Big Daddy's chest and feel that brass. Old school simps are also all over college campuses and all over the radio stations, pushing books that set these females up for disaster by encouraging them to think like men when they have not mastered being women yet. Simp number three is the sport coat. And sport coat is a term we used back in the day to describe these brothers who are always looking to catch another player slacking up on his pimping, so they could drape their coat over his woman's shoulders and play the concerned gentleman who cared about her feelings. Sport coats lived to be the rebound guy, making easy buckets off the glass after you missed the free throw. And I'll give you a good example of this. Had an incident in college where this brother waited for me to leave for the summer just so he could sport coat my ex-girl. And even though she and I weren't talking to each other or anything by that point, we did decide to, you know, just be mutual friends and see if our flames could be rekindled once the school year picked back up in the fall. The day I left to go back for the summer, I saw this brother watching me as I was driving off. And I got an eerie feeling at that moment because it felt like he was a buzzard circling over my head, waiting for my ex to pass out from heat exhaustion so he could just pick her apart. I wasn't gone from the school but for 5 hours, and the ex called me up the moment I got home, telling me the main man was talking to her and telling her what type of dog I was, and that I had 5 or 6 other chicks on rotation, rolling in and out of my dorm room like they were a nursing staff and I was their patient. And with me being gone and both of them staying up at the school during the summer, main man kept leaning on my ex, telling her how much pussy I was getting on the side during the school year, and that she deserved so much more than me. And I couldn't really defend myself from his mudslinging attacks from far away. So My ex ended up believing that bullshit and falling for his game. Needless to say, they still married to this day. And that's my point. Sport coach simps are always looking to score some easy points with a female by grabbing an interception and taking one to the house after you done forced pressure to make the female run out of the pocket and throw that duck across the field.
As the pass went up, Johnson sprung into action. It was Jimmy Mackey's 9th interception of the year.
Okay, you did all the grimy work, but the sport coat is the one who gets the highlights. He's the cat that the homecoming queen is kissing on the cheek after the game. Number 4 is the brother who is a total simp out of fear. Alright, these brothers stick out like sore thumbs, and they usually join the feminist cheering section because they are terrified and so afraid that their wife or girlfriend is going to make them sleep on the couch and not give them any pussy that night.
And I'll have a french fry, as I mean the fruit cup.
Oh. These dudes inbox me and hit me up on Facebook and YouTube all the time at the behest of their woman, talking about, man, you can't talk to these women like that. And I do nothing but laugh because it shows just how weak our infantry unit is if all you have to do is get a few women to go on pussy strike. Some of these dudes are so whipped and henpecked, they can't hold out for a single day without wanting to rub up against their woman's leg like a stray cat, praying he gets a bowl of milk. Number 5 is the most dangerous simp of all, because he has caused the most disruption through the fraternal order of manhood. And that is the mama's boy who was raised to be nothing but a simp by a mother who holds grudges against men. Tupac Shakur was a prime example of the mama's boy simp, and I'll explain. Now, there's nothing wrong at all with showing love and affection to your own mother. It shows that you have compassion and that you have a deep appreciation for the sacrifices that your mother has made in order for you to live. Now, for the past few decades, we have heard men dedicate countless songs to their mothers, from old R&B classics like Sadie by the Spinners to Boyz II Men's inspirational tune Mama, which was displayed in the film Soul Food. But in the song Dear Mama, Tupac tells us all that his anger would never allow him to show love to his stranger of a father, which is understandable considering that children should be angered about the absence of one of their parents. But at the same time, Tupac states that even though his mother was a crack fiend, that she was a black queen.
And even as a crack fiend, mama, you always was a black queen, mama.
Okay, this is clearly damaging, because it shows you that this man would stop at nothing to defend even the most negative and harmful behavior that his mother displayed. That is mama's boy simping to the core, because it demonstrates that these men will honor any and every action that their mother has ever done, all the while denouncing their own manhood, because they will stand by the standards that only abusive women have set for them, no matter if these women are alcoholics, drug addicts, or abusive in any other way to them and others. The mama's boy simp is really a victim of feminism. And in Tupac's case, it speaks for itself, because here is what he told Vibe magazine about his father. I thought my father was dead all my life. After I got shot, I looked up there, and there was this nigga that looked just like me. And he was my father. That's when I found out. We still didn't take no blood test, but the nigga looked just like me, and the other niggas did. So now I feel that I'm past the father stage. I do want to know him, and I do know him. We did talk, and he did visit and help me when I was locked up, but I'm past that. Okay, that was Tupac's interview with Vibe magazine's Kevin Powell. shortly before he died, this was in June of 1996, Tupac's biological father was an ex-Black Panther named Billy Garland. Garland was still a teenager when he met Afeni Shakur, who was also a teenager. And a year later, their short union would produce Tupac. Now, there are no excuses being made for Garland's lack of time with his son, but there are two sides to every story. So let's compare the life he lived and the life of that of Afeni Shakur. Now, Garland was more than likely no saint, and none of us men are. But he did manage to become a gainfully employed man who got married, and he did remain in the life of his other children. Garland also never moved from outside of the New York and New Jersey radius. While Tupac's mother, Afeni Shakur, was a full-fledged drug addict by the time Tupac was a toddler, she moved from Brooklyn, New York, where Tupac was born, to the Bronx and other locations all over New York before leaving for Baltimore and later to the West Coast, living in and out of tenements and homeless shelters from time to time with other drug addicts. Now, a mama's boy who was doing some heavy-duty simping will blame all the misfortunate circumstances that Tupac went through as a child on Garland, and make no sort of mention to the fact that Afeni Shakur's drug habit or the fact that she lied to her son and told him that his father was dead as a determining deterrent to her son's future. Our overall society has been simping as well. And the proof is in the pudding, because while Garland is still viewed as a scoundrel by the masses, Afeni Shakur was praised all over talk shows and invited to the speaking engagements all over the country, where women would pat her all over her back as if she did some top-notch parenting.
I am a product of the redemption of Christ Jesus. I need to tell you that. I'm not ashamed of it. It's not old-fashioned. It's what's new and vibrant in my life. So I want you to know that. So, and the other thing I want to tell you is that everything else that I'm about to tell you is because of God's glory, all right? Yeah. It's not because of anything that I've done. It's because of God's glory. So for me, I believe, let me tell you this also, in the Black Panther Party, we failed because we took God out.
In the D.C., Maryland, Virginia area, better known as the DMV, and I could tell you that drug dealer Rafael Edmonds was another man that fit this description of the mama's boy simp. Effeminized from head to toe and doing exactly what mama taught him. In fact, his mother was so naive, she actually thought she was going to get away with the information the police had on the wiretaps from her phone conversations with the family friend that turned into a federal witness against his criminal enterprise, because she was speaking in pig Latin as if the prosecutors wouldn't be able to decipher that language.
Now, for those who don't know, pig Latin, you just take the consonant from the beginning of the word, slap it at the end of the word, and add the A sound. And for vowels, you just add the syllable wet.
And if you think that's something, I'll tell you another story. One of my sisters owns and rents out a small property to people in the Section 8 program of where I won't say. But I remember when she got her first location off the ground and running, one of her first tenants was this sorry-ass woman who was a single mother of four children using her kids to sell drugs for her in and around that neighborhood. And I remember when we evicted them, her only damn concern was how her kids were going to collect the money which was owed to them by drug addicts that they spotted dope to. Now, any reasonable person with a sound mind would say that this is a horrible woman who has no business raising children. But a mama's boy, simp, would defend this woman by telling you something like, man, how else her baby's gonna eat? Or say something else stupid like, but she a good mother though. At least she there for her kids. Where they dead yet? And I'm gonna tell you all that we have a mama's boy, simp epidemic going on in this nation right now. especially with more than 72% of black children being born to single mothers and another 60% born to women who have procreated with more than one man at least once. Like I told you before, the mama's boy simp is the worst of every simp I have described because they are totally irrational. And even if they themselves grow up to eventually get married and live what seems to be a productive life, they tend to carry lots of inner hatred for the men who never raised them. And they use this prejudicial bias they have developed to keep women elevated to a matriarchal hierarchy above all men.
In ancient time, and one of the things you can look at and see in remote time, most of the men resemble females. Most of the pharaohs, most of the men, they resemble. Look at Akhenaton. He looked so much like a female.
Boy George did too.
Most of the men resemble females. Most of the men resemble Akhenaton. He looked so much like a female. Look at Akhenaton. He looked so much like a female. This is male egotism. That's how it is. You know what men are? Men, and listen, this is a hard pill for us to swallow, because we men. A man is nothing more than a degenerate woman. A man is nothing more than a degenerate. A man is nothing more than a degenerate woman. A man put the child up to the breast and feed it. I can men put the child up to the breast and feed it.
Who's wearing the pants? Who's wearing the pants, nigga? If you ask me, I think that her dick is bigger than your little dick. And I'm telling you, Jake, the bitch got you locked down like Pelican's Bay. Now I told you if you fuck with the hoe, she's guaranteed to have you tripping. And me and you set tripping. I told my motherfucking crew to kidnap the hoe, and they came back with some. I can't fade a nigga that's bitch made. Kool-Aid pumping, tell a bitch something. She'll have your ass cooking dinner while she's letting every nigga in the hood run up in her. Got you running like Bruce Jenner and the whole beat. Pussy whipping your ass like Toby. Now you act like you don't know me. Only a mark. I put a homie for the homies.
One of these motherfuckers different. Tell me a secret, not just any secret, just answer one question for me, baby. Do you love me? I love you very, 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 very much. Can I come pick you up and take you shopping? Spend all my money. Soon as I get home from work. I love you. I love you.
Don't put a hoe before the homie.